What's up, guys? Welcome back to Poke Central. Now in this video, I have another top 10 video to bring you guys, and this is the top 10 best starters. So this is all opinionated. This is all my own opinion, and when I make the list, you could obviously tell which type I prefer better: water, fire, or grass. So you definitely will be able to tell. And this, I will be putting a little backstory to the reason why I picked these Pokemon for their special spot. And don't be offended if you're, like, let's say, don't be offended if your favorite starter Pokemon is on the list. Tell me your favorite starter Pokemon, and yeah, you guys will find out my favorite starter Pokemon. So let's get right into this video with number 10. Number 10 is Cyndaquil. Now, Cyndaquil is number 10 because when I first got Soul Silver, Cyndaquil was the very first Pokemon I picked, and I always loved how it followed me, because that's the first game that I played that it could follow you, because I played Soul Silver before I played Platinum. But, and also throughout the whole entire journey, Cyndaquil was extremely strong. It went to Quilava, then Typhlosion, and I only had trouble, or I can think of right now, is, I think it was only Lance that I had trouble with, but obviously with the rest of my team, I took care of Lance. So, Cyndaquil got number 10. Let's go to number 9. So, number 9 is Chikorita. Now, I don't have a really good explanation for Chikorita, but number 1, I really like grass starters, and I always like Meganiums and Chikorita. And number 2, I always like the episode in the anime where this one, when I think it was Indigo League, where I think Ash met this girl that liked baseball, and she had an Electabuzz and a Meganium. And I've always loved Meganium since I saw that episode. So that's a quick explanation, and let's get to number 8. Number 8 is Totodile. Now, I've picked all 3 Johto starters back to back to back, but Totodile got the edge over all of them because I've had a ton of great games with Totodile. A ton of great Let's Plays in HeartGold. One of them, I had a Togetic, an Ampharos, Feraligatr, Donphan, and I think an Ursaring. And that was one of my best playthroughs ever. And I had so much fun doing it because I did it on vacation with my cousin, and it was really fun. So there's really no explanation for that besides what I just said. That was number 8. Let's go to number 7. Number 7 goes to Bulbasaur. So I picked Bulbasaur because I really like grass starters. Bulbasaur, in my opinion, is the strongest Gen 1 starter, but a lot of you guys are going to have different opinions, like Charizard and Blastoise, but I think it is Venusaur. So I always loved Bulbasaur. When I watched the Pokemon Advanced Battle episode where Mei got a Bulbasaur in, like, the grass heaven, I guess. So that was always my favorite part of that episode and my favorite part of the journey when Mei got her Bulbasaur. So that was number 7. Let's see what number 6 is. Number 6 is Turtwig. Now, Turtwig and Torterra, they're very special because Turtwig was my first Gen 4 Pokemon that I've ever got, and that was the first Pokemon I picked, and I remember trading over my Torterra to Soul Silver because I was having trouble with Lance, and at the time, my Torterra was like level 80, so it made Lance much easier, and that's kind of cheating, but I don't really count it as that much of a cheating, just more of helping me with my own Pokemon. That was number 6. Let's get to number 5. We're already almost halfway done with the list. Number 5 is Squirtle. I put Squirtle for number 5, even though I think Venusaur is stronger than a Blastoise, is because when I played X and Y for the very first time, I picked Chespin, and then when I got to the point, I picked Squirtle. Just because I don't like having two of the same exact types, which would be Grass, Chespin, and Bulbasaur. But I picked Squirtle, and I think almost for everyone that played X and Y, that was That was probably one of their best games ever. I know a friend of mine, that was his best game ever. He had all level 100s on his team, and that was really strong. And he had a Jolteon on level 100, which I can never beat when we battled. But when I did eventually get a Blastoise, it made the game so much easier with Team Flare and everything, because Team Flare mostly has fire types and dark types, the main typing of the bosses. But that's all I had for Squirtle, and that's it. Number 4 is Treecko. Now, this explanation is pretty short, but when I was playing Alpha Sapphire and Omega Ruby, I've had at least 5 Sceptiles, and Treecko was my very first starter that I picked, my very first Gen 3 Pokemon. So that was clearly very special to me, and that was a really quick one, but that's it already. Number 3 is Chespin. Now, I don't really need to explain Chespin, just that Chespin is amazing. Chestnut is amazing. Quillodon is something else. I don't really know how to explain it, but Chespin is really special to me because when I went in Nintendo World for my first time in New York City, I got a baby Chespin plush, and it is literally the cutest thing ever. And I also have a regular Chespin plush, and almost all of my playthroughs with a Chestnut, I had no struggles because the other Pokemon on my team helped me through them. But that's pretty much the main reason why everything is on this list. But one of the main reasons why I chose Chespin is way too long to say in this video, but I did say in my top 10 favorite Pokemon list, which is one of my first videos on my channel, so go check that if you haven't already, and you will find out the main reason why Chespin is on this list. Number 2 is Rowlet. Yes, Rowlet. The second that I saw Rowlet, when Pokemon on the YouTube channel released the starters for Sun and Moon, I immediately fell in love with it. Number 1 being that it's a grass type, and who doesn't love grass types? Actually, no, quite a few people that don't like grass types. But anyway, I was instantly on Team Rowlet. I didn't even think for a split second to pick Popplio or Litten. And I just had my mindset on Rowlet the whole time. And when I was looking through about like a month later, when the final forms, Decidueye, Incineroar, and Primarina, when their leaks were released, or not really released, but someone found those leaks, then I thought, in my opinion, that it's one of the coolest Pokemon ever, Decidueye. The way it looks is just amazing. And for a while, my home screen on my iPad was Team Rowlet. So yeah, Rowlet's pretty lit. Jordan Team Rowlet. And it is time for number 1. Now, some of you may know what it is. Some of you may not know what it is. But get ready. It's a big one. And the number 1 spot goes to Snivy. Yes, I am not joking. I love Gen 5. It is by far my favorite generation, just because I grew up on that generation. Pokemon Black and White were my very first games that I've ever got for Pokemon because of my friend, but I will not say his name because he does not want it to be mentioned. But he greeted me into the world of Pokemon. Thank you so much for him. I would not be here right now, actually. But Snivy was the first Pokemon I ever picked in my whole entire life, the first Pokemon we ever have, and Superior was my first Pokemon that ever got to level 100. Now, it's a shame that I forgot the rest of my team. I can't even remember one Pokemon that was on my first team, but I really wish I could just change everything. I would still pick Snivy, but change my team so I would actually remember it. But yeah, that is my top 10 favorite or top 10 best starters. And if you guys didn't agree with me, comment down below. Fix my list if you would want to. Just do whatever floats your boat. And I will catch you guys in the next video. Don't forget to like, subscribe, comment, share. And see you guys later. Goodbye.